How you can change your negative behavior in positive behavior and how you can become aware of your behavior. Hi guys, I'm Fabio De Sio and welcome to my YouTube channel. And this is the map of be yourself, trust yourself, value yourself. And this is the month where I'm going to talk about mental health, but not only as I said this month. But today the topic is NLP and reframing. What is NLP? As I said, every week I'm going to talk about the video before I was talking about some issues. How can we solve these issues? Today I want to talk about NLP. That can solve many issues. NLP is a big tool that I'm using with my clients, and it's called the Neuro-Linguistic Program, and it's how you can change your negative behavior in positive behavior, and how you can become aware of your behavior, and how you can change that, your partner, that it's so difficult sometimes that we don't know yet how to change it. So this is the reason because why today I want to talk about NLP. And it's really an amazing tool. First of all, I would like to talk about the part that is really important for me as someone who uses NLP, this technique. First of all, this technique is based about some communication, the way we communicate, about our body language, about the way we speak, the way we move our facial expression. So this is a part of NLP. But one of the best way to use this technique is reframing. Now all of you are thinking, Fabio, what does it mean to reframe? I'm here to tell you. Are you ready to know what does it mean to reframe? I hope that you're ready because I am. Reframing is about you that come to me, we start talking, and I'm going to ask you some questions about a situation that you really were not happy that this situation happened in your life. Something really negative was for you that situation. Sometimes it can be many times. You can be in some places where there are too much noise, or you can be someone in your workplace that did something that you were not happy, like these people, I'm joking. But there is always a reason behind a negative pattern, or we have something that really, we try all the best to find a solution to stop, but we still think of that situation or that scenario. It happened to me as well. I was really not obsessed about when people were thinking, especially about a friend, really was thinking that I was sure that there was something between from me and him. He was not a close friend. He was someone we had in the same, we used to meet in some place. And I didn't know why this person didn't like me. There was so many, I was feeling really low most of the time, and there was all the time a negative, and there was so many negative thoughts around this person. But after I've been helped, of course, in my life, as you know, I did many therapy, coaching, I did them as well, and now I know how to do it myself. So I say, let's understand the situation, the scenario. And I did as well with my client. Let's understand your scenario. Okay, take a piece of paper, start writing your scenario. Every time I was meeting this person, what was the situation? Really writing piece without being an observer, observing the situation. And I did the same with my clients. Say, let's understand when you had this issue, what was the situation? What makes you unhappy about that situation? And after what I found it in my case, I found that this person was having the same feeling around me. Most of the time, we are part of this emotional reason, most of the time are irrational, are unrealistic. What does it mean, emotion? There are so many different emotions, but sometimes we don't understand them. And when my client as well had these issues in his workplace, so we were trying to understand what the reason And after he knew it, the reason was only in his mind, because when people, they didn't want to talk with him, it was because he didn't do anything to talk with them. So we tried to understand together, to write on a piece of paper, to go back on this piece of paper, as well when he said that my boss doesn't like me because he never asked me anything to do, to go out with the friends, but I asked it to him, have you ever done something to be available, to be part? And as well when he said, oh, my boss he hates me, I said, what are the proof? This is the big question. What are the proof of your reason? Because this is a question where you have to think about. And he said, oh my God, he wants to offer me a cup of coffee. So I said, the situation of what is the proof that you can show me? I say, okay, this person really hates me. Like me, in my case, this person really don't like me. It was only my mind. It was a moving that I built. Reframing is the base on this concept. When you reframe a scenario, you think, okay, my boss is a person who we don't talk a lot, but at the same time, he respects me. Because in that case, with my client, the problem could be that he could lose a job, he could go away because he had this negative thought in his brain. So let's understand you, our pattern, write the situation every time you think something happened to you. Try to get what is the real emotion, the real feeling that really makes you uncomfortable. And let's reframe this uncomfortable situation. Let's reframe all together what's going on, why, what was wrong. As well with this period, we are all tired, we are all exhausted, we are all feeling, oh, no. But let's reframe this situation. I'm going to reframe it with my opinion. This situation happened for a specific reason, because I could grow as a person, as a coach, as someone who can help my community, the LGBTQ community, and I want to become a voice for my community, and something amazing will happen in June. There's so many things happened. Think about that. Reframe your negative moments. Reframe if something doesn't like you, because you can change it. And I really believe it, that if you change it, your life will be amazing. Your life will be full of great experience, and you can make a difference too. Like most of us, we need that, especially in these difficult times. So I hope that you enjoyed this talk about NLP and reframing. I will do more, because people are asking, because mental health is fundamental. We all have to have a great relationship with our mind and our brain, with everything. I hope that you enjoyed my video, and remember, be true to you. Bye bye.